Hi everyone! Welcome to NMEC Kids Worship. We're so glad you're here to worship the Lord with us. Israel and Judah, governed predominantly by evil kings, continued to disobey God. God sent prophets like Elijah and Isaiah to reveal His power, love, and faithfulness to His people. God reminded them of His plan to send a rescuer, Jesus, to take away their sin. We continue our series on God the Revealer today with the story, God Called Isaiah. Before we begin, here are three simple rules to follow. I can listen, participate, learn. Let us begin with a word of prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us together on this wonderful Sunday morning. What a joy it is to worship you with our teachers and friends. May you be honored in our praises today. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. Let's sing out loud and worship the Lord together. Let us recite our Lord's Prayer in Chinese. Gun di ti tiang e pe, guan di emia zui xing, di e go gang dim, di e zi yi di jia di dui tiang, qin xiu di ti tiang. So yu yang e bi niu, gina di qiu su gun, xia bian gun e zui, qin xiu gun ya xia bian diak zui gun e lang. Bo ti ho gun du diu chi tam, qiu gun tua di pai, in wi go guan yan geng long si die, di gao dai dai. Amen. Big picture question. How many gods are there? There is one true God who alone deserves worship. Our key passage is found in Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 to 2. In the past, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, He has spoken to us by His Son, whom He appointed heir of all things, and through whom also He made the universe. Over the past weeks, we've learned about the kings and prophets in the northern kingdom of Israel. God's people were living in sin, and God kept sending messengers to warn them about their problem. We learned about Elijah and Elisha, and this week we will learn about Isaiah, another prophet of God who had a message for the people in the southern kingdom of Judah. Our story for today is God Called Isaiah.
After King Solomon died, the tribes of Israel split and formed two kingdoms, the northern kingdom of Israel and the southern kingdom of Judah. The people in these kingdoms looked to their kings to protect them and take care of them. At this time, the king of a land called Assyria was trying to take over the world. When Uzziah was the king of Judah, he was mostly a good king. The people felt safe. When Uzziah died, the people of Judah were upset and afraid. In the year that King Uzziah died, Isaiah was worshiping God in the temple when he had a vision. Isaiah saw God sitting on a throne. God's robe was long. Its edges filled the temple. Seraphim, heavenly beings, stood above him, and they each had six wings. They called out, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. His glory fills the whole earth." When the seraphim spoke, the foundations of the doorways shook, and the temple filled with smoke. Isaiah was in the presence of God. He said, "I am ruined. I am sinful. I do not deserve to be in the presence of the King, the great and holy God." Then one of the seraphim flew to Isaiah. The seraphim had a burning coal from the altar in his hand. He touched Isaiah's mouth and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your wickedness is removed and your sin is wiped away." Then Isaiah heard God's voice, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?" Isaiah said, "Here I am, send me." "Go," God said. God told Isaiah an important message for the people. This was God's message. "You will listen, but you will not understand. You will look, but you will not really see. If your eyes and ears and minds worked, you would turn from your sin and be healed." Isaiah asked, "How long should I preach to people who won't listen?" God answered Isaiah, "Preach until the cities are destroyed and no one lives in them. I am going to send the people far away." Then God explained that he would bring some of the people back to Judah. These people were part of Abraham's family. God was going to keep his promise to Abraham through them. He would send the Messiah through their family to be a blessing to all the nations. Isaiah had a vision of God's glory and realized his own sin. God forgave Isaiah's sin. Like Isaiah, when we see how holy God is, we see how sinful we are. God sent his son, Jesus, to take away our sin. We can find salvation only in him.
So, what did we learn from our lesson today? We learned that Isaiah saw the holy God in his glory and realized his own sin. Like Isaiah, when we see how holy God is, we see how sinful we are. God sent his son Jesus to take away our sin. We can find salvation only in him. Let us close in prayer. Lord, we praise you for being the one true God. Only you are worthy of our praises. Thank you for sending Jesus to cleanse us from our sin. Help us to live for you and love you most. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's learn more about this lesson in our class activities today.